Hi guys, and welcome back to Bitesize Excel. In this week's video, we're going to take a look at conditional formatting with icons. Now we're going to look at two different examples of how to conditional format using icons. The first is going to be Excel's built-in, so if we come to conditional formatting, our icon sets. And the second is going to be using some of our own symbols and conditional formatting those. So to do our first one, let's look at this first example. So we've got some example data showing 2020 and 2021. And financial figures for each, and we want to work out the change between the two. Now in this example, the easiest way to do conditional formatting is to work out the change in a separate cell. So we're going to go equals 2021 minus 2020, and we're just going to quickly copy this down. And we can see our changes there, positive in some months, negative in others, and no change in others. And we're going to come to our conditional formatting and pick an icon set, say these arrows. And you can see what it's done is it's selected those that are the highest, the green arrow, the lowest with the red arrow, and everything in between with the yellow sideways arrows. Now this isn't quite what we want. We want anything above zero to be the up arrows, below zero to be the down arrows, and then anything that is equal to zero being those sideways ones. Now we could have done this when we set up our icon sets originally by going in and clicking more rules, but if you've got them in you want to adjust, instead come into your manage rules, select your icon set and click edit rule. And you can see here that what it's done, it's saying that when the value is greater than 67% is giving you that green arrow, anything above 33%, so between 33 and 67, is giving you that yellow sideways one. And below is the red arrow. So if we change this instead to number, and if we say anything that is greater than zero is going to be the green arrow, click this one to number, anything greater than or equal to zero, so essentially zero, is going to be the yellow, and anything below, red. Click OK and apply it, or just click OK. And you can see that we've now got the result that we expect. You can also format it so it's only showing the arrows and not the numbers themselves. So if we were to go back into Manage Rules, Edit Rules, we'd check this Show Icon Only box. Click into that, click OK, and apply that. And you can now see that we have the arrows exactly as we want them. You can also add your own icons in and conditional format using those, which we're going to show now in the second example. So in this, I've got a number of scores, good being above 60, poor being below 40, and average being everything in between. And what I want to do is I want to put in some smiley faces, depending on which bucket these scores fall into. So what we're going to do is we're going to come to our Insert tab and go to Symbols. Now I've got my smiley faces down here at the bottom in terms of recently used symbols, but I could also find them by coming to this list, scrolling down to my windings, and you can see that your smiley faces are over here. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to insert these by double clicking on them and then click close. There we go. I've got a smiley face, a neutral face and a sad face. They're coming up as J, K and L in here because the formatting is actually that windings formatting. But I'm just going to copy those down. So this is how I want to score them. And the best way to get a formula returning these types of symbols is to look at the character code. And to do that, we would come back to our symbols. And when you click on any symbol within this set, you can see that it has a unique character code. So the smiley face is 74, the neutral face is 75, and the sad face is 76. So we'll just come out of that again. I accidentally put a sad face in, we'll take that out. So this was 74, this was 75, and this was 76. I'll just pop them in here so that we can remember what they are. Now if you were to type a formula equals character and type in that character code, so 74, and hit enter, you will get it returning that particular character. Now it's appearing as a J because that's how it sees it if you don't have it as this windings formatting. But that's pretty easy to change. We type this and update it to windings, hit enter, and you've got your smiley face. And what we're going to do is we're going to wrap this up in an if formula to bucket all these scores. So we're going to say if our score is greater than 60, we're going to have that character 74. Then we're going to say if our score is less than 40, We're going to have that character 76. And then finally, for everything else, we want that character 75. And close all our brackets and hit enter. And you can see we've got that neutral face because 57 is between 40 and 60. And we can again just copy this down. Now I've used a nested if function there. You can use any other kind of function that you'd like, such as ifs, depending on the result that you want. Now finally, what we want to do is we want to format these so that they're appearing color-coded depending on whether they're the happy face, neutral face, or sad face. So coming back in, selecting my cells, coming back in and going to conditional formatting, we're going to go to new rule. We're going to say format only cells that contain, so a cell value that is equal to, so equals character 74. And we're going to format that. And we'll give it a grid of green background, green font text, and we'll make it bold. And then we'll do the same for the other two. So cells that only contain equal to equals character 75. We're going to format this. Again, we'll make it bold. Put it in orange, and we'll give it a bit of a background fill. And then finally, we'll do that sad face, so character 76. And we'll format that with a red text, make it bold. And you can see now that we've got our conditional formatting with our custom symbols. And if I were to change some of these scores, say I were to put this one to 75, you'll see it's changed to a smiley face. If I were to put it to 15, we get a sad face. That's just a quick overview of two different methods for using icons and conditional formatting in Excel. Do you have any specific examples of where you might use this? I'd love to hear your thoughts in a comment. I hope that you found this video useful, and I do look forward to seeing you again in future videos.